So we've learned about Beer's law, and we've learned that if we graph absorbance versus concentration, we get a straight line. And the name of the graph is a calibration curve. So basically what Beer's law says is when we're dealing with solutions that have a color, we can change the concentration and we can also change the size of the container that they're in. If you make a solution more concentrated, the solution gets darker and it absorbs more light. More specific to the mathematics of it, the concentration, the factor that you change it by, so if you double concentration, it doubles the absorbance. If you triple concentration, it triples the absorbance. That's what's known as a direct proportion. The width of the container is known as the path length. It's an actual distance that you can measure. If the path length gets wider, there's more solute particles for the light to travel through. So as the path length gets bigger, the absorbance also gets bigger. And just like the concentration, the path length is directly proportional to the absorbance. So when we have direct proportions, dividing them produces a constant. And so if we put both of those fractions together, we end up with this overall fraction here. And when you divide them, you get a constant. The constant is given the Greek letter epsilon, and it is known as the molar absorptivity constant. So what we would like to know is if we can figure out what that constant is, we can take measurements in order to determine any one of those variables that are in the equation. What you're going to look at later is how you can figure out the concentration. So the concentration can be known if you know the value of the constant, if you know the path length, you can measure that, and if you know the absorbance of the solution. So talking about the calibration curve says that the absorbance is directly proportional to the concentration. So this is like taking a little piece of Beer's law and making it into a graph. When you have a direct proportion, the two variables will produce a straight line. Straight lines have slopes. And what most people will say if they're asked to define what a slope is, this is slope is the rise over the run. By rise, what we mean is the rise is the y-axis, is the one that goes up and down. So that's the y-axis. Divided by the run, which is the horizontal axis, which is the x-axis. And now we have a graph where we have something, some measurement on the y-axis, and that's going to be absorbance. So rather than saying y, I can put in absorbance. And then rather than putting in x, I can substitute concentration for that. So what we end up with is an equation that looks like this. Slope equals absorbance divided by concentration. So here is the equation we just made, absorbance over concentration equals slope. Here is the equation for Beer's law. And what we can do is take these two equations and notice that they both share something. They both have absorbance and they both have concentration. So we can take the equation for Beer's law and rearrange it so that it has this same exact sign, so that it has A divided by C. So what we're going to do is a little bit of algebra where we have the equation equal to A divided by C. So if you look here, we have A over C already in there. All we've got to do is just move the path length over to the other side. And the way you do it is you multiply. Okay, so that cancels. And then what we're left with is absorbance over concentration equals the constant times the path length. So now what we've got are two equations that both have the same A over C. And the reason that that's important is because when we have matching sides, we can take the two equations and make one equation out of it. So that's the next step. Merging these two equations together. So what's important to see here is that they both have A divided by C on one side. So there is a bit of mathematical reasoning that goes on here. What it says is that if you have two equations that are equal to the same thing, they are equal to each other. So essentially what we can do is take these two and merge them together. So if they both equal A over C equals L times C, and A over C equals slope. If we just take the A over C part out of it, so let's just erase that. We can now put an equal sign in between them. So in rewriting this, we can say that the path length times the constant equals the slope. So recall what we're doing here. The whole purpose of this is to figure out what the value of this constant is, or an equation that we can use to calculate it. So now if we have this as our unknown, this constant as our unknown, what we're gonna need to do is move the path length over, and algebraically what you're gonna do is divide. So slope over L, that cancels. And what you're left with is the constant equals the slope divided by the path length. So now we have an equation where we can take some measurements and determine what the slope is by making a graph. And we can directly measure the path length using a ruler. And from that, we can figure out what this constant is. So the next step of this lab is going to be you preparing a series of solutions from that copper sulfate solution that you made earlier, where you're gonna know what the concentration is. So these types of solutions are known as standard solutions. They have a known concentration. Then what we can do is we can take each one of them and put them into the spectrophotometer. So each one will take a turn in the spectrophotometer. And for each one of these, you can measure the absorbance. So what you'll have is a series of four concentrations and four corresponding absorbances. You can plot them on a graph. You'll have these four points here. And if you do a good job, you should have four points that form a straight line. Using Excel, we can have Excel tell us what the slope of that line is. So the slope will be from Excel. And so that's the next step of the lab, is to make these solutions, make the graph, and then do a series of calculations where you can determine the constant.